Another good aspect of ethics in the same phylum is never go for any leg pulling of anybody. If your colleague or if your competitor is growing and rising, what are you supposed to do? If your competitor and your colleague, if he is growing and rising, what are you supposed to do?
Cheer.
Somebody from this side? What are you supposed to do? Is now you are in the atmosphere of ethics. So you're going to give me the right answer. putting your hand on your chest, I simply say, sometimes you don't get indulged into the right kind of practices. And to more of that, sometimes we go for leg pulling as well. If you can work, you are working with an open brain. If you can work with an open heart, fine if somebody rises. Be happy. He has risen with his own abilities, with his own hard work, and with his own connections. You rise with your abilities, with your hard work, with your connections. God has given you brain and heart. When our Guru Parampuja Pramukh Swami Maharaj, today he is 95, he is in the Guinness Book of World Records 6 times. He could appear for many other times. He has been described by the Guinness Book of World Records as the master builder of the 21st century. And you see Swami and Akshardham at New Delhi, such a campus on 235 acres of land is coming up at Robbinsville in New Jersey, America. By 2020, we are going to inaugurate it. What I mean to say is, he is a person who has done lot of social work, lot of cultural work, lot of work, selfless service in the field of medical, cultural, social, environmental, everything. He has dealt with thousands of people of all class, right from a layman to well-educated, well-experienced people, architects, engineers, professionals of all kinds. He was once asked, which thought remains with you forever? A very good question. To a person of this rank, to a person of this ability, to a person of this magnanimity. He was asked, which thought remains with you? And Pramukh Swami said, the thought which has never entered my mind, shall I tell? And that was more interesting, isn't it? If we were asked this question, which thought has never entered your mind? I don't think we'll be able to answer this question. It's difficult to grasp something which has never entered our mind. And you would say it confidently. And Pramukh Swami Maharaj said, the thought of ever hurting anybody, physically, mentally or emotionally, has never entered my mind. And that is why such personalities could do that great work. I would suggest a book for everybody. If you have a piece of paper and pen, you can write. Well, all of you have been given pens and you can write it. The title of the book is How the Mighty Fall. The title of the book is How the Mighty Fall. And the author is Jim Collins, one of the top management gurus that we have in the present day world. I repeat, title of the book is How the Mighty Fall. Author is Jim Collins, he's a management guru, he's a trainer for corporates. He has so far trained thousands of executives of Fortune 500 companies. And out of his more than 30 years of experience of dealing with corporates, he has written this book, How the Mighty Fall. That those kind of people who would put their foot on ground and the ground would shake, that powerful people. Those people who could be sitting on one of the top floors of a Manhattan building and could topple a government in Africa, that kind of powerful people. Those kind of people who would sneeze and Wall Street would catch fever. That class of people. How did they fall? They were all termed as mighty. If you sneeze and Wall Street catches fever, then you are a mighty person in the financial markets. How did this kind of people fall? Why did they come crashing on the ground? Why are some of them behind bars today? Why some of them have gone bankrupt today? It's a good 250 or 300 page book. I recommend to all professionals. You must read this book. But I give you the gist in one line. Shall I? Or you want to go and read the book? You people are hardcore professionals, so you want to just in one line, don't read the book. No, today as part of my talk, I must share. Sushil, you brother? As part of my talk, I must share. The one line gist of this book is Jim Collins, after all his experience of more than 3 decades of dealing with corporates and writing this book thereafter, he writes that the principal reason, the one line reason behind the fall of such mighty people was, now I'm again quoting him, not word to word but letter to letter. He writes, undisciplined pursuit for more. I want these words to sink into your head and mind. So I repeat. Jim Collins writes, undisciplined pursuit for more. That these people in the pursuit of more and more, that is money or some other profits of other types and gains, of fame, of popularity, of turnovers, they went into the undisciplined mode. That is, they didn't follow the disciplines, that is ethics. You got my point? So they went into the undisciplined mode and they paid the price of it. Undisciplined pursuit for more. You can have a disciplined pursuit for less, that is more acceptable. That can sustain you for longer in your working career. That can build up your reputation gradually. That can give you a good progress. But undisciplined pursuit for more is poison. One day you definitely pay for it. I definitely suggest this book. Another good book that he has written. Again, you can write the title of it. Next time, probably if we meet, Sushilji. Next time, probably if we meet, I'm going to ask you people, if you have read this book, and I'll ask you, some of you, to come on the dais and tell me a gist of it, okay? I know this both books in and out. So I'll ask you to narrate me a few paragraphs, not word to word, but something of it. The second good book related to this, Jim Collins has written, the title of the book is Good
to Great.
To Great. The title of the book, You Are Good. You are fine, you are a good professional, you want to be great? Again in that book, the one principle that he has always put forward on each and every page is ethics. Very clearly it is, you might also have an experience in your surroundings that some people with good talents, good intelligence, larger resources, better platforms, and more backgrounds, still they fail. And some with the lesser of all this, they still succeed. Yes or no?
Yes.
You might have met such people, or at least heard of such people. Yes or no?
Yes.
Why? Ethics. With ethics imbibed in you, with lesser of this, you will succeed. And with no ethics, with more of all this, talent, intelligence, know-how, resources, backgrounds, platforms, you can still fail. And when you know that if you fail after 30 or 40 years in your career, it's difficult to start again. It's very difficult to start again. How many of you have heard the name of Rajat Gupta? Just raise your hands and keep your hands up. I want to see. Most of you. The face of corporate India in the Western world. IIT Kharagpur graduate. IIT Delhi alumni as well. Harvard MBA. Alumni of Harvard. A professor at the management program at Harvard. Director at Goldman. And director at many such places. He was the face of corporate India in the Western world. Many of you know the case. I'm not going to go into the details of it. Just in a few lines, what is reported in the newspapers and what has been proved in the US courts. One fine day, Warren Buffett, the richest person upon this earth and the richest investor, he offered his personal $5 million to Goldman as investment. And the board of Goldman, they met in Moscow, Russia, to decide upon. And they decided, well, we must accept this $5 million. That is a credit to Goldman as well. When Warren Buffett is putting his personal $5 million. Next day, the announcements were to be made. It is said, as proved in the US courts, and as reported in the media, the Rajat Gupta coming out of the boardroom, he made just a 5-second phone call to his partner Rajaratnam, one of the companies that he privately hold. Raja, it is said, assume, pick up Goldman as much as you can. So that gentleman, Rajaratnam, a Sri Lankan, Rajat Gupta's partner, he started picking up Goldman, that is shares, millions of dollars in few hours. And the market started going crazy. Next day morning, 10 a.m., the announcements were made. $5 billion, Warren Buffett putting his personal investment into Goldman. And as usual, what happens? The price of the shares go sky high. And it went. Initial 2 hours, they still purchased. And by noontime, they started. What did this do? By noontime, they started. Selling. I think you all know the procedures. Theoretically. Started selling, made about $3 million by evening time. Roughly, $2-3 million. Isn't that good money? In 24 hours? You make a lifetime money. $2-3 million, American knows better. $2-3 million in just 24 hours in a deal. One government attorney by the name Preet Bharara, he started backtracking. How could somebody purchase millions of dollars of Goldman the previous day and next day these announcements are made and the shares rise and this guy sells it off and he makes millions? How? That means this guy must have some. This is the exact word, inside information. And you know this word, inside information or insider trading is a big, big crime. In the US it is a big crime. So it was all backtracked, cases filed, and the US court, they convicted Rajaratnam first. After conviction, sentence was pronounced. 12 years in jail. Today it is the 4th year. Rajaratnam is in jail. For Rajat Gupta, many NGOs, many international personalities, they personally wrote letters to US courts. That this gentleman has helped us a lot and he has this NGO and he has a lot of social work and this and that, so you please pardon him to the maximum that you can. Many such letters. And still he was convicted. He accepted, and then in the packed courtroom, the conviction was announced. Rajaratnam was already sentenced, but Rajat Gupta had nothing but tears in his eyes. And with eyes full of tears, His eyes, it could not open to see into people's eyes. And with dropped head, he could say only one sentence, which has become a red light, a warning light for all professionals all over the world. Rajat Gupta said, my 40 years of corporate image building has gone down in drains in 5 seconds. If it can happen to Rajat Gupta, can it happen to you, me, anybody? 40 years of corporate image building can go down in drain in 5 seconds by a non-ethical practice. Rajat Gupta had to spend 2 years in jail. Just about a few days back, the last few weeks or a couple of weeks, he was sent back into house arrest from the jail. You might have read in the newspaper, he's now under house arrest. No unethical practice. AK-47 can land you 5 years jail. Hope for a good tomorrow. Important is this. And those people who have worked ethically. A very good name of an Indian businessman for whom everybody has a respect as a man of ethics. I want the name from you. Ratan Tata. Everybody's opinion was same. We all came up with one name. I think all of us agree?
Yes.
A man of principles, a man of ethics. What he did after the Taj attack is unbelievable. We all know, I think. So I'm not going into the details of it. A man pure of ethics. When he saw a young couple on a two-wheeler with their small little baby in the heavy showers of Mumbai in a rainy season, struggling to start their bike, and the lady running for some shelter with that little baby, and the gentleman kicking the two-wheeler. Ratan Tata was passing through that road, sitting in his Rolls. He saw this. And he writes many years later, with tears in his eyes, he gave a commitment to himself that I must give a car for 1 lakh rupees. That is a very nominal price to each and every Indian. Every Indian family must have a car. And when he launched Tata Nano at Delhi, at the auto show, a reporter was there to ask him something about this. And he said one sentence that is again become very popular in the corporate world. And now that is a green signal, a go-ahead signal for each and every professional. Anybody of you remember that words of Ratan Tata? You must, you are professionals. These are something you must definitely inscribe in your hearts. Ratan Tata said, yes, somebody?
100% made in India.
100% made in India, of course, that was. Regarding ethics, when we are talking of ethics, he said, a promise is a promise. This is ethics. I promise to the people of India this car, and I'm launching it today. A promise is a promise. This is it. And that is why it's love. Second important ethic at workplace, which is also equally important, is your attitude at the workplace. Your attitude at workplace. Somebody works or not beside your table, you are least concern. You have to put in all your effort daily. Yes or no? Simple. That should be the attitude at workplace. If you work with that attitude, only then you will enjoy your workplace and your work. See, if the light goes in America, that is electricity goes in America, the light is off, what do the Americans do? They pick up the phone and dial the electric company, straight away. What if the light goes in Japan? They are all good self-workers. You would find a stool from somewhere in the house, you will get on top of it and try to fix the fuse. So if the light goes in America, he calls the electric company, and if the light goes in Japan, he starts fixing the fuse. And what if the light goes in India? He just opens the window and says, "Sabki gayi hai na, jaati hai. Sabki gayi hai na, jaati hai. Baith jayega ghar mein." Attitudes are very important, and that is one of the principal sources of success and happiness at workplace. If your attitude is right, if your attitude is positive, no obstacles can really prove a hindrance to you. That attitudinal power has this consequence. Edwin Moses, the great hurdler, 110 meters hurdles, more than 50 international and world championships won. 110 meters hurdles. Every 10 meters you have a hurdle and you have to jump and run. More than 50 gold medals at international competitions. And today at present he is the chairman of the International Athletic Federation, based out of London. Edwin Moses, popularly known as Ed Moss in the athletic field, after his retirement, when Reader's Digest interviewed him, so he won 50 gold medals in the international level. This is an unbelievable accomplishment in your life. For any athlete, it's a dream come true. With which thought you used to run the hurdles? With which thought in your mind you used to run the hurdles? And he said, which has again become very popular, he said, "Hurdles are those which you see when your eyes are off the goal. Hurdles are those which you see when your eyes are off the goal." My eyes were straight on the finishing line. That is attitude. Somebody is not helping me and somebody is this. You give your 100% energy. That kind of attitude is very much important. That is very important. Again, not the attitude of procrastination. Our Guru Pramukh Sahib Maharaj many times says, ki agar aapko vichar aaya, if you have thought, ki ye kaam main 2 second ke baad karunga, to bhi wo alas, it is procrastination. You are lazy. If I will do this work after 2 seconds, if you get that thought, you are lazy. Prabhupada Swami Maharaj, who is creator of Amin Akshardham, he has written and answered more than 7 lakh letters during his time, lifetime, at an average of 70 incoming letters, mails and fax per day and outgoing. It needs tremendous discipline at work. And it does not require, or it does not allow even a second of delay and a second of procrastination. This is out of his heart that he has said this. Such people, they work with this kind of attitudes in life. I'm going a bit quick. Another third good attitude in life, at your workplace, ethics in profession, is your man-women discipline at your workplace. This comes as Stree Purush Maryada at your workplace. Now you must be finding increasingly more cases of sexual harassment at your workplace. And you might, that means hearing the stories. Yes or no? Has this increased day by day? Yes or no?
Yes.
Everybody say yes? Tell me.
Yes.
And it is still going to increase. We have to work together. Men and women are equally placed to work. Both have the equal rights to work. But the disciplines of interactions, the disciplines of working together, the disciplines of caring and sharing with each other has to be maintained. If you don't maintain, it is a serious breach of ethic in your profession. And you can pay a heavy, heavy price someday. The biggest example of this happened recently, just about a few months back. Who knows the name? Another big name. You are talking of Terry Channel. Suresh Pachauri. As reported in the newspapers. Another big name. The president of the International Monetary Fund. The Frenchman by the name Dominique Strauss-Kahn. Popularly known in the financial circles as DSK. The man who was the president of IMF and destined to become the president of France. He flew from New York, had a stopover in London, checked into a hotel and was supposed to fly after a few hours back to Paris. That is his home country. As reported in the newspapers, a few minutes of misbehavior with a maid who had come inside his room just for some cleaning purposes, and that maid, she went to the court. And many weeks later an out-of-court settlement was made. But Dominique Strauss-Kahn had to put in his papers as IMF president. He had to resign. He had to withdraw his nomination from the presidential race in France. And today he is a simple economic advisor to a small country of the former USSR, maybe Ukraine or something. Otherwise he would have been sitting with the G people. G7, G8, G15, G30, whatever. Or the G class. That means you would have been sitting with Obama or that or Angela. But just a small disciplinary mistake. It is not allowed at that level. You must be very, very careful about this. It can ruin your career within seconds. Do you accept this statement of mine? If yes, then raise your hands. Everybody has raised their hands. This breach can ruin your career, ruin your life within seconds. Tiger Woods. Even your name is Tiger, you become a rabbit. You know the whole story. Even Fanish Murthy, as reported in the newspapers. CEO of iGate. And a person who had the capacity to turn around any software company which has become a sick unit into a huge millions of dollars profit making company. He had that knack when it comes to software companies to transform them into from a sick unit to a multi-million dollar company. And he did it 3 or 4 times in his career. For the 4th time he did it to iGate as well in US. Again, he had relationships with a colleague. Maybe the relationships went sour. She reported, and according to the norms of the company, if at all you have a relationship with a colleague, which is an extramarital relationship, you have first to report. Or any other relationship, you have first to report to the management of the company that we are into a relationship. If you are not reported and you are caught, you are finished. Fanish Murthy was thrown out. With all his bonuses and everything, he had to compromise much. This particular aspect of disciplinary ethic has the power to crush you within seconds. It is also very important ethic in profession. Now if I had told you, if I had started the lecture with a sermon of Ramayana, that Tulsidas has written in Ramayana, Pardhan patthar maniye, parstri mat saman, itne se hari na mile to Tulsidas jaman. If I had started with this, you would have said, oh my God, how did we come here? Or why did I come here? Main kahan yahan phas gaya yaar, ye Swami ji ko Ramayana ki baat chalu kar di. Lekin ye kitni sach hai. पहली बात क्या लिखी तुलसीदास जी ने परधन पत्थर मानिए दैट इज द वेल्थ दैट डज नॉट बिलोंग टू यू इज लाइक स्टोन्स दैट इज पेबल्स एंड मड फॉर यू इफ रामलिंग राजू ऑफ सत्यम एंड ओबेड तुलसीदास इफ Somebody at Sahara had obeyed Tulsidas.